Sir.
Okay. So yeah, after having known the fundamental difference between analog signal and digital signal, so let us now dig into the details of analog to digital conversion. So I took this slide from analog devices slides. Yeah. Copyrights belongs to them, so I hope they allow us to use their slide. So because they are one of the best, of course, company in the world that built analog to digital converter components. Of course, now more and more analog digital converter is being integrated or inserted built in into the microcontroller or microprocessor. Yeah, so with all the brands of microcontroller, in Arduino usually you use what? I forgot, microchip, something like that. But if you would like, sometimes for some application, the standard micro, the standard analog digital converter, or ADC for short, that is integrated in the microcontroller is not enough for some application. And usually in biomedical application, many times we require that special application, right? So in that case, that occasionally we may need to use a dedicated analog to digital converter. So in that case, then we can use analog digital converter that is dedicatedly fabricated or available as standalone component and by analog devices. Of course, it is not the only manufacturer of analog device converter, analog to digital converter, ADC device, yeah, there in the market. There are some other companies as well. So we will, of course, reintroduce again the concept that I have explained just now in the previous session, more or less the same, but a little bit quicker. Yeah. So we will study what is the A to D fundamental here. So as we can see here, that similar like I have told you that the A to D fundamental is the two stages available or carried out in any ADC. The first one is sampling, basically is the process of discretization as a function of time, as a sampling period. The second one is quantization. Quantization is where the levels of the signal is being quantized, being rounded to the closest staircase steps. Then we will study some factors affecting analog to digital converter performance, either static performance or dynamic performance. Then some algorithm, or we call it in ADC as architecture, that are quite common in ADC component, like successive approximation registry, analog digital conversion. This is successive approximation, SAR. Stands for successive approximation. Then pipeline analog digital conversion, flash type analog digital conversion. Yeah, I mentioned a little bit in the previous session. This is one of the quickest algorithm to do analog digital conversion. So the PA sampling period will be very small. So it's very quick. If we require very fast responding, quick responding instrument, then we need to, maybe we can use this fast type ADC. Then sigma delta ADC, which is now quite popular to be used in the market, sigma delta analog digital conversion. Then we will consider some application of high speed ADC. Okay, then so ADC basically in any signal processing loop or in a measurement loop, it is the basic step before a data is being put or inserted into microprocessor or microcontroller or digital signal processor. So in microcontroller, microprocessor, or digital signal processor, all the data are already in digit. So usually the chip here is completely digital IC, digital circuit. Yeah, so, which is, it has a certain standard in the micro fabrication technology in microelectronics technology. So, but before it can be processed there, of course, the data from the analog signal has to be converted into the digital domain. So that is the role of analog digital converter. So the data from the instrument comes to the multiplexer here. So if, for example, we need to take data from multiple instrument, then we have, as we have discussed in two previous session, operational amplifier, right? Differential amplifier, instrumentation amplifier. We haven't discussed maybe isolation. Oh yeah, we have discussed a little bit about isolation amplifier. We have then discussed some analog digital signal processing, yeah, although more on the filtering side. We have discussed a little bit on log logarithmic amplifier, of course, but the others we haven't really discussed. Frequency to voltage or voltage to frequency converter, multiplier or divider in the analog domain, and RMS to DC converter. So then it is converted to digital. Then later, if we would like, and sometimes also in the instrument, a measuring instrument itself can also have digital to analog converter, where it needs to have a control over the transducer. And in that case, then the digital analog converters is required. Okay. So how to do this? Then from there, from digital analog converter, it become analog. Then we need another analog signal processor itself. So the filtering circuit that you have learned in the previous session is not only used when the signal, before the signal is being converted in ADC, but also used for after the signal is being converted in the analog domain, digital to analog. Yeah, so before it can be used to control a motor, for example, or a lamp, for example, because the signal, let's say, some example here. So here, for example, the signal would still looks like after digital to analog conversion, yeah, it's already continuous, but may still contain some, let's say, ripple, yeah, due to the high frequency, high frequency part of the digital signal. So this is the role of the analog signal processor, for example, to make it smoother. So to make it smoother means to have low pass filter, for example. So then from it becomes smoother before it is either amplified or being attenuated and then sent into the several different actuators. Okay, so this is why also we need analog signal processor, yeah, after the digital analog converter, so in the analog domain. Okay, so but what we are going to learn now is focus on the analog digital conversion, not on the digital analog conversion, although in some way, in some stages, they have some similarities. So let's say here we see real world sample data system consists of ADC and DAC. So in any sample data system in actual instrumentation, it contains both analog digital conversion and digital to analog conversion. So in the analog domain, there's a channel, and then from the channel, the signal is converted into digital using ADC, and then from the digital, it is being processed using DSP, digital signal processor, in the form of either dedicated DSP, yeah, so DSP is digital signal processor, or otherwise it could be also be processor, yeah, microprocessor, multipurpose microprocessor, could also be microcontroller. Then, if you want to control either the transducer or any actuators, then we use DAC here. So in the analog domain, as we have discussed in the previous session, the signal is continuous both in time as well as in its analog amplitude. Okay, so when the signal is being converted, yeah, here we see that first the signal is being sampled. Yeah, the term sample here means here there is T here, yeah, this is T, sampling period. Yeah. So this is 0, this is NT, or 1T, this is 2T, 3T, etc. until NT. Okay, so where it is being sampled and discretized into signal, a function of the multiplication of the sampling period. Not anymore the function of continuous time parameter. Afterward, it is being quantized. See, we see here the steps. Yeah, so it means any values in between will be lost. The values, any values there will be rounded to the closest steps or staircase. So when it is being converted, then it becomes not anymore a continuous signal like this, but instead it becomes point within certain time. With a certain time of which is a multiplication of the sampling period, and also the value itself is already digitized or quantized, yeah, to be closest to the steps, depending on the resolution of the quantization. So similar when it is sent to DAC, to digital analog conversion. So this is usually how it looks like. Yeah. So it cannot be. So from here it become like this. Yeah. And the reconstructed waveform may not be that continuous yet. But that is why we need another filtering or analog processor, signal processor to save to be able to smoothen this data before we send it to any actuators. Okay. So what is an analog digital converter then? Yeah, in short, it is some device that used to convert analog signal into digital output signal using a reference input. The reference input we have mentioned in previous session as the voltage reference from where then we can obtain the quantization value. Yeah? So the digital output code, as we mentioned, is it will depend on the analog input divided by this reference. So multiply by 2 to the power of n minus 1. It means that the higher the n, the larger the n, then we will obtain better resolution. So the resolution is defined here as the bits of the sampling, or the bits of the quantization n bits. So an analog digital converter produces a digital output corresponding to the value of the signal applied to its input relative to that reference voltage. So that's why if our reference voltage is 0 to 10 volt, for example, we cannot apply that 12 volt or 15 volt. So we have to attenuate it first to maximum 10 volt. On the other hand, if our output is, let's say, from ECG is 0 to 10 millivolt, yeah, in order that we can make use the whole resolution, the whole range of the analog digital conversion, so that then we can process it better, yeah, we can have better accuracy, it's important that we have to amplify first, so that then the upper range of our analog signal match that of the reference value. So if our analog digital converter reference voltage is 10 voltage, the range, the quantization range is from 0 to 10 voltage, then you have to make sure that you process your analog signal so that it has also 0 to 10 volt range between the minimum and maximum. Yeah, so if it has minimum value, minimize value, you have to put it upward, make an offset so that it becomes 0 to 10 volt. So then this will goes, the whole range of the analog signal will goes into the whole range of the ADC, so that then the more data can be converted into digital signal. Otherwise, for example, if you amplify only 0 to 5 volt, right, then there is some range in the analog digital converter from 5 to 10 volt, which you don't use. So mean you lost them, you lost this resolution. Some of the resolution are, yeah, some of the bits you don't use in the conversion. Okay, so the output, yeah, it is a finite number of discrete value. Discrete means that discretized in time, with the value is also discretized or quantized with the value of to the power of n, resulting in quantization uncertainty. Yeah. In the quantization uncertainty, then changes continuous time signal into discrete time sample representation. So from continuous time signal into discrete time sample representation. And sampling and quantization impose the fundamental yet predictable limitation. Okay, it means that sampling and so it means what, as I've mentioned in the previous session, that how many sampling you do every second, and then to how many steps in the quantization you have will determine the limitation of your digital signal. It will determine then the accuracy and the resolution in terms of time, how much the signal you lost, in terms of the accuracy, how close your quantized signal can approach the real analog signal. So in the sampling process, this is the first process we have discussed in the previous session. This represents a continuous time signal. It's still continuous time domain signal. So it means the value is still continuous and the Y value, but at discrete and uniform time interval. So some signal between the time interval will be lost in the period between the sampling. So it determines the maximum bandwidth of the sample of ADC or the reconstructed DAC signal, based on the Nyquist criteria. What is the Nyquist criteria? We see that for Nyquist criteria, it means that your sampling, in order that you can reconstruct the or represent the original analog signal close enough, your sampling frequency, this is Nyquist, or sometimes called as the Nyquist-Shannon criteria, because it is discovered or invented by Shannon also, not only Nyquist, from the theory of information. FS has to be larger or equal at least than the two times of the maximum. Maximum frequency in that signal, in the bandwidth of the signal. So for example, let's say ECG, electrocardiography, we know that the bandwidth is between 0 to 100 Hertz. It means in order that your ECG signal is accurate enough in the discretized, that it can reconstruct the original ECG signal, it means you have to sample at least 200 sampling per second. At least 200 sampling per second, because you know that the maximum frequency in the ECG signal is 100 Hertz. Yeah. So if you sample the same 100 Hertz, then you will lose some of the signal. Significantly, that you cannot reconstruct the original ECG signal. At least 200 Hertz, but better if you can sample 400 Hertz. Even better, 1000 Hertz. So then you can represent the tiny changes. Tiny or means quick changes in the ECG signal. So what we call as, if it is not 200,000 Hertz, for example, less than 200 Hertz, less than two times of the maximum frequency within that signal, then we will have what we call as aliasing for ADC or images for DAC. So an example is, let's say, a simple sinusoidal signal, just like this, okay? Even if you sample two times, of this frequency, two times the frequency. If you sample, let's say one time, you sample this one. One time means every one period of the signal, right? So see what we will obtain is the signal here, same here, then another peak again here. So you will obtain flat signal. Your sinusoidal signal loss. Okay, you cannot reconstruct that sinusoidal anymore in the digital domain. Let's say you now sample two times. So instead of here, you also sample here, you also sample here, you also sample here. So the reconstructed signal will be here. So what you will obtain is, well, close to sinusoidal, but not close to sinusoidal, right? It is instead a sawtooth signal, triangle wave signal. But if you sample even more than just the two times the frequency, let's say four times, then you also sample here. So usually it is different color. So you may obtain something better like this. May still look like a triangle, but maybe closer. And even if then you choose eight times mean you also sample here, then your reconstructed digital data will be closer to an actual sinusoidal signal. So this is what we call, when it is less than two frequency maximum, your reconstructed digital data cannot resemble the original analog data. What we call here is aliasing. So that is why it is important that your sampling frequency has to be larger than at least or at least similar to two times the maximum frequency part in that domain. Okay, so in the quantization process itself, as we have also discussed earlier, so it round the value and value to either the lower part or upper part of that step. In this step, the higher the bits resolution, the closer the step, which is then it means it can resemble the actual analog signal more accurately. So in the quantization process, we represent the analog signal having infinite resolution, the original analog. Infinite resolution means it has any number of value in the real domain in the y-axis can be represented by the analog signal. But now we represent them with a digital word having finite resolution, quantized. There's not all value data is can be taken, but instead it is quantized. So it determines the maximum achievable dynamic range in the quantization process. Determines the maximum achievable dynamic range. It will also result in quantization error or noise. Yeah, why? As we have discussed also, because of this rounding process, some value will be lost, as we have put in one example. Some example below, if our quantization is only 1 fold, yeah, then 0.6 will be rounded to 1 fold, 0.3 will be rounded to 0 fold. So the error will be 0.4 and 0.3. But if we have instead the quantization is every 0.5 fold, the quantization step, then 0.6 will be rounded to 0.5, 0.3 will be rounded to 0.5. The error is becoming less, so become 0.6 fold and 0.2 fold respectively. Okay, so this is what we call as quantization error or noise. If we have the step even smaller, let's say 0.1 fold, then that 0.6 and 0.3 can be represented without any error at all, right? So then the error noise can be decreased, can be lessened. So the quantization process determine the maximum achievable dynamic range of our measurement. So here, so any in this is the FS is frequency sampling. This is the quantized digital data. So here, any value, for example, here between this and this, let me use annotation. Yeah, any value between this and that part will be rounded to this value. So this value will be rounded above, yeah, while this value will be rounded downward. So any analog input in this range give the same digital output code. So it means between this sampling frequency, yeah, between this part and part, all will share the same value, just one flat. Yeah. Then after that, when it becomes higher than this 1.0, half of the 1.0 level, it be rounded to the upper value, which is 1.1. Yeah, so it takes a new value of 1.1. Yeah. So similarly with downward, when the value continuous value here decrease and below the half of this between the step of 0, 1 and 1, 0, then it will be rounded to 0, 1 here. So in after this quantization process, this is what we have. Yeah, as I have drawn earlier as steps. Yeah, I draw also the line downwards to show the line, the time where it located in time. So basically, but it is the same here. Okay, so that value, this is called as one least significant bit. One least significant bit is the value of the between the steps. Okay, so for an ideal converter, something like this. Okay, and when we have an analog input here, this is the corresponding digital output. So this is the case for 3-bit quantization. So from 0 until 8, yeah, from 0 until 7, sorry, from 0 until 7. So it 8 level. 8 level is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And this is the ideally, this is the least significant bit. For example, from 6 out of 8 will be between in between 5 and 6 level here, and between 6 and 7 level. So it will be rounded to 1, 1, 0, yeah, 6. Above the half of the 7 to 8, it will be rounded to 1, 1, 1, including when the value is similar as the maximum, as the reference value itself, it will be rounded to 1, 1, 1. So it doesn't have any 1, 0, 0, 0 value. So then the quantization noise will be here. Yeah, represented by the, this is the quantization error. So you will have zero error here. If you see same notation here, you will have zero error at this part when it is exactly, of course, at the 1/8, yeah, of the full scale. Sorry, full scale is not frequency of sampling. FS is full scale value. Yeah, full scale value. Not frequency of sampling. And below that, yeah, below that, the more until it reach half, yeah, until it reach half of that 1/8 value of the full scale value, yeah, it will be rounded up to the 1/8 value of the full scale, or 0, 0, 1 will be rounded up. But closer to half, so you see here the error increases when it goes down, as well as increases when it goes up here, but with different sign, yeah. In the sign here of the error is positive, means that the rounded value is higher than the actual analog value. So this is negative because the rounded value 1/0, 0, 1 here, yeah, which is basically 1/8 of the full scale, is smaller than the actual rounded value, the actual analog value. So let's say if this is the full scale is, let's say, 10 volt, for example. So this one will be zero. So this will become 1.25 volt. This is 2.5, 3.75. This becomes 5, 6.25, 7.5, and 8.75. So if you have, for example, name it, 5.5 volt. What to do with 5.5 volt? 5.5 volt, the middle of 5 and 6.27 to 6.25 is how many? 5.675, right? 5.675. So 5.5 volt is here, right? 5.5 volt is here, somewhere around here. So it will be, sorry, here, yeah, it will be rounded down to five volt. So it will have this value, 5 volt, which is basically half of 10 volt. Half of 10 volt means in the 3-digit representation is 4. Yeah, 3-digit means 0 to 8, right? So 4 is 1, 0, 0. Yeah, it becomes 1, 0, 0. The error, on the other hand, see, so the error, because it is rounded down from 5.5 volt towards 5 volt. So the error is 0.5 volt, and 0.5 volt here, if you see, is minus, yeah, because it is it is rounded to the lower value. That's why here it has this error of minus 0.5 value. So the one LSB bit here represented as how many? 1.25 volt in this case. Yeah. So 1/8 multiplied by the full scale range, 10 volt. One over two. And this is the formula for LSB. Sorry, let me... One over multiply by full scale. So in this case, 1/8, right, to power 3 is 1/8 times. Let's say when it the reference value is 10 volt, so this becomes 1.25 volt. In the middle, one the middle part here from here to here is the half of this, yeah, zero. So the error range is from minus 0.675 until 0.675 volt. Okay, clear until here? No questions? I hope it's clear. Yeah? So yeah, this is the quantization noise as we have mentioned earlier. So when it is exactly at the value of the full scale range divided by the digit, by the bit, yeah, then the noise will be zero. Well, but if it is more than that, it will be rounded down, then it becomes negative. Yeah, the noise will be negative. If it be less than that value, that quantization value, then it will be rounded up. It means then it will have a positive quantization noise. Yeah, so the range of the quantization noise is minus Q over 2 to plus Q over 2. So in the previous example, we have 3 bits resolution and the reference voltage is 10 volt. So least significant bit is 1.25 volt. Then the quantization noise ranges is minus 0.675 volt until plus 0.675 volt. The RMS value, root mean square value of the quantization noise sawtooth is the peak value, its peak value, which is Q divided by Q, divided by square root of 3, or Q divided by square root of 12. Yeah. So in different words, this is the RMS of sawtooth wave. Yeah. Q, the Q here, Q is basically here. Yeah. This is Q, the LSB. So the RMS will be equal to Q divided by 2 divided by square root of 3. So if you put the 2 into the square root, it is Q divided by square root of 10. This is the root mean square of the quantization noise. For sine wave full scale, RMS value is 2 to the power of n minus 1 divided by square root of 2. For sawtooth, the quantization error, signal root mean square value is Q divided by square root 12 here. Thus, signal to noise ratio is from here 2 divided by n minus 2 power n minus 1 divided by square root of 2. Yeah. Then multiplied by this. Divided by this. This is the signal. Yeah, this is the signal. The 2 power n minus 1 divided by square root of 2. Yeah, then multiplied, divided by the noise. The noise is Q divided by square root of 12. So the signal to noise ratio is 1.225 times 2 to the power of n. It means when you have more bits, more quantization bit, more resolution we call it, then the signal to noise ratio becomes better. The signal to noise ratio increases. So usually we express this signal to noise ratio in terms of dB. So this becomes minus log minus 10 minus 10 times the log of this, so this become 1.76 plus 0.02 n, where n is the resolution of the analog to digital converter. So the signal-to-noise ratio gets higher when N increases. That is why when you have 12-bit resolution, it is better than 8 because of that N. That 12-bit become this N. 12 times this, of course, plus this, yeah, is higher than 8 times this plus this. Okay. Okay, let's have a break because of the time. And we will continue to the next session, continuing about the process of analog to digital conversion.